Hello everyone. Today we'll be studying the fourth type of filter after the bandpass filter, that is a band reject filter. It is also called as a band stop filter or band elimination filter. Now in this filter, frequencies are attenuated in the stop band while they are passed outside this band. That means it will work just opposite to your bandpass filter. In the bandpass filter, the required frequency will be passed, whereas in the band reject filter, whichever the portion of frequency we do not require, that particular frequency band will be rejected or eliminated, or it is stopped from working. So it is called as a band stop filter. Since we are eliminating that particular band, frequency band, it is called as band elimination filter. So in this filter, frequencies are attenuated in the stop band while they are passed outside this band. Now here also in the band stop filter, it is classified into two different types. One is called as wide band reject filter and one more is called as a narrow band reject filter, like how it was there in the bandpass filter. Now wide band, it is similar if your Q value is lesser than 10, that is quality factor or what you call it as a figure of merit. So if the Q value is less than 10, then it will be considered to be a wide band reject filter. Similarly, if a narrow band reject filter Q value is to be greater than 10, then it is called as a narrow band reject filter. Now when you consider this narrow band reject filter, it is also called as a notch filter, because if its higher Q value, which is considered to be greater than 10, the bandwidth of the narrower band reject filter is much smaller than that of a wide band reject filter. We know that since it is having a wide band, that means the frequency or the bandwidth what we have, it will be a very much broad, so it will be the bandwidth will be more, whereas since in the narrow band the Q value is greater, you get narrow kind of center frequency in the center, so it is called as a narrow band. So since the band is very less in case of narrow bandpass reject filter, so the narrow band filter will have the bandwidth very much smaller than that of a wide band filter. Now coming to the wide band reject filter, so this wide band reject filter is a filter which uses a low pass filter section, a high pass filter section, and there is a summing amplifier. So it consists of a low pass filter, a high pass filter, and a summing amplifier. Using these three combinations, we are going to build or we are going to design a wide band rejection filter. Now to realize this wide band reject response, the lower cutoff frequency we take it as FL for the high pass filter, whereas FH will be the high cutoff frequency of a low pass filter. Now to realize the response, we consider that FL should be greater than FH, so that the pass band gain of both high pass and low pass filter must be equal. Now this is a filter where is the high pass section we have considered, because the input what we are giving to the non-inverting terminal is through a capacitor, so it is a high pass filter section. Then it will be a low pass filter combined. There is a resistor to which we are giving the input, so there is a high pass filter, there is a low pass filter which is given. So the top section is the high pass filter, the lower section is the low pass filter. Now two different filters are considered. Now there has to be a summing amplifier to be given. So this is a whole design or circuit of a band reject filter. So we need to produce a frequency only for one particular frequency, say for FH, the low frequencies will be passed. Then it has to be neglected. Then it has to pass the high frequency. So for that we are taking a high frequency and the low pass frequency. So both will produce the frequencies. For the above section will give you the frequency which are greater than FL. The below circuit will give you the frequency till FH. So in between that, FH and FL, which should not be passed, will be rejected, whereas those two frequencies will be added up by using a summer circuit. So this is the overall wideband reject filter design. Now if you see the frequency response of this wide band rejection filter, it is something like, so you can see that the pass band is from 0 to FH. So 0 to FH is called as the pass band of the signal, So which is giving you the frequency from the lower 0 to FH hertz. So which is the similar working of your low pass filter. If you come to the next part, FH, FL, we need to reject it. So the rejected band is those frequencies. So which will start decreasing. Suppose if you are considering first order, it will be minus 20 dB per decade. Now next, from a particular frequency, say FL is the cutoff for your high pass filter. So from that high pass filter, we are increasing the frequency so that you need the filter to pass the higher frequency after that lower cutoff value. So this lower cutoff value will be considering such that it will pass only the frequencies which are greater than FL. So a high two pass bands are there in the frequency response. In the middle portion in between FH and FL, so we are rejecting the band. So if you realize the band reject response, you can see the FL, which is the lower cutoff frequency of high pass filter, should be greater than the higher cutoff frequency of a low pass filter. So this is one of the important thing in the response we need to understand. So this is how is the wide band rejection filter works. If you consider the problem to design a wide band reject filter, which is having the higher cutoff frequency as 200 Hz and if FL is 1 kHz. So by seeing the question itself, you can see FL is greater than FH, which means it is a wide band rejection filter. Now first we need to design a low pass section. We'll start designing a low pass section. So to design, again we have to understand, we have to take a capacitor value for low pass section. The higher cutoff frequency is 200. Let us assume the C value as 0.05 microfarad. We know R is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi FHC, which gives you 15.9 kilo ohm. Then again, we have to design a high pass section. For high pass section, the lower cutoff frequency is given as 1 kilohertz. Consider the C is equal to 0.01 microfarad. R is equal to 1 by 2 pi FLC. Again, you will get it as 15.9 kilo ohm. Now we know that whenever we consider the passband gain as 2, for all the design problems, we have considered 2 because the same thing is considered to be for the cutoff frequencies. So RF is equal to R1, which is equal to R1 dash, which is equal to RF dash. That is, R1 and RF is for the low pass filter. High pass filter. R1 dash and RF dash is for the low pass filter. So considering all the cases as equal to 10 kilo ohm. Now next is, you need to design the summing amplifier. We can make the gain of the summing amplifier. We can choose it as 1. So that R2 as well as R3 as well as R4, you can consider it as 10 kilo ohm. And we know from the circuit, R2 will be parallel to R3 parallel to R4, which you will be obtaining as 3.3 kilo. You can see the circuit, the same problem circuit is drawn in the figure. The R1 and RF is for a high pass filter top portion, whereas down is R1 as well as RF dash, which we have considered is for the lower low pass filter section. So 15.9 kilo ohm is given, 0.01, 0.05 for low pass filter. And you can see the output of the op-amp, which is R2, R3 as well as R4, we have considered it as 10 kilo ohm. Gain of the summing amplifier is 1. So when you are designing as R2, R3, R4, if you consider the total resistor value, that is ROM, which is equal to R2 parallel to R3 parallel to R4, which you will be getting it as 3.3 kilo ohm. So you have to draw the complete circuit of the figure because it is asked to draw the circuit and design. So same circuit is drawn in the frequency response where you will be having FH will be equal to 200 hertz. So 200 to 1 kilohertz, the frequencies will be rejected. So which will be the wide band portion which you can show in the frequency response. Now here voltage gain, if it is changing at a rate of, so since we have considered the first order, because you can see the circuit, one capacitor and one resistor is used to the input of the op-amp. So voltage gain changes at a rate of 20 dB per decade above FH and below FL, so with a maximum attenuation which occurs at FC. So if there is maximum attenuation occurring, you can see that there was a narrow peak coming in at FC. So that is the maximum attenuation which you are getting where all the frequencies are rejected at the frequency that is FC. Now next is, we have a narrow band reject filter. Now, narrow band reject filter, it is also called as a notch filter, which is used for mainly rejection of a single frequency, such as 60 hertz power line frequency hum. What we call here is, we'll be considering only one frequency. At one particular frequency, we have to reject. So it is called as a notch filter, mainly for rejecting a single frequency, 60 hertz, 80 hertz, like those kind of. So narrow band reject filter is also called a notch filter, because higher the bandwidth, that is Q value should be greater than 10, narrow band filter, which is much smaller than the wide band filter. So it is mainly or commonly used for rejecting a single frequency hum. So the most commonly used notch filter is a twin T network, which is shown in the figure. So this figure is called as a twin T network. Now here, this is a passive filter component of two T-shaped networks. So you can see it is just the components which we are using is only a resistor and a capacitor. So it is called as a passive filter. We know if there is no application of any active component along with a passive component, no active component along with a passive component, then we call it as a passive filter. So since there is no active components used here to design the filter, it is called as a passive filter. So this particular passive filter is having two T-shaped networks. So if you observe clearly, one T network is R1 and RF with 2C. So R1 is equal to 10 kilo ohm, RF is equal to 10 kilo ohm. There is a capacitor which is having a value 2C. Similarly, there is one T, another T network, which is having two capacitors, C and C. And there is one resistor joined to that is R by 2. So this particular filter is a passive component filter, which is composed of two T-shaped networks. So one T network is made up of two resistors and capacitor, while the other uses two capacitors and a resistor. Now here, there is a frequency which is considered. The notch out frequency is the frequency at which maximum attenuation occurs, so which is denoted by Fn. So Fn is called as a notch out frequency. We need only a single frequency. So that is considered to be a notch out frequency, which is called as the frequency at which the maximum attenuation occurs. So it is given by a formula, that is 1 divided by 2 pi RC. Now this particular passive twin T network has relatively low figure of merit, that is the Q value what you take. So that is very low in terms of passive twin T network. So Q of the network can be increased. So if you want to increase the Q value of the network, it's this same circuit, it has to be used with a voltage follower network. So you can see the figure. The left part of the circuit is a twin T network and the right part of the circuit is a voltage follower. We know the voltage gain of a voltage follower is 1. So whatever the input you give, the same will be getting across the output. Now to use or to get the Q value, the figure of merit value more, so what we do is, because the main function of when we say a narrow band, it is nothing but the Q value should be greater than 10. So to achieve it, we are going for a twin T network. Twin T network will be combined with a voltage follower network. So by using this, we can increase the Q value of the network and then we can use it as a narrow band reject filter. Now the frequency response of this particular narrow band filter looks something like this. So you can see that. So once again, there are two pass bands, one stop band. Whereas when we compare this with a wide band reject filter, you can see the bandwidth of the wide band reject filter is more compared to the bandwidth of the narrow band reject filter. So FH, one particular frequency has been eliminated, that is denoted as Fn. So the frequency response almost remains same, but the only difference is in the bandwidth of the frequency response. So this particular notch filter, they are mainly used in communication and biomedical instruments, mainly for eliminating the undesired frequency. Suppose we don't want a particular range of frequencies to be passed. So that time, those are called as undesired frequency. So those undesired frequency, if we need to eliminate, then these particular filters are used. So to design a active notch filter for a specific notch out frequency, say Fn, you need to choose a value, that is capacitor should be again less than or equal to 1 microfarad. then we need to calculate the value of equation. From the equation of fn frequency, we need to calculate the value of oil, that is to design. So we can see the design by using an example. So you have to design a 60 Hz active notch filter. The question is given, you need to design a 60 Hz active notch filter. The first thing is you need to consider the capacitor value. So here I've considered the capacitor value, say it is 0.068 microfarad. So use the formula of notch filter frequency, Fn is equal to 1 by 2 pi RC. From the same equation, take out R is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi Fnc. Substitute 1 by 2 pi 60 into 0.068 into 10 to the power minus 6. So you get the value as 39.01 kilo ohm. So since standard value is 39 kilo ohm, you can use the 39 kilo ohm resistor. Now, suppose if we want R by 2. So you can see the same figure design is used here. So this is the design of the filter. So you'll be using a filter using the R value, which has to be taken as 39 kilo ohm here. For R by 2, what is given there, for that you can use parallel 39 kilo ohm resistors. And for the 2C components, you can use parallel 2 parallel 0.068 microfarad capacitor. So this is how you design the band reject filter of a narrow one, whereas the formula for wideband filter will be calculating mainly the high pass filter section, low pass filter section, then a summer section. So this completes the band stop filter. Thank you.